Hey everybody, Mary Z back once again with Voice Hacks. I wanted today to tackle in this tutorial a voice myth about screaming. Today I'm going to answer the question of, if you don't cool down your voice after you do any sort of distorted singing or screaming, that it will permanently stay that way. Is it fact or fiction? Today I'm going to tell you the truth in my latest tutorial. I've seen a few different videos and a few different things going around saying that if you stop screaming or if you stop doing distorted singing or something like that, that you absolutely need to cool your voice down with some clean singing in order to prevent damage or to prevent some kind of permanent raspiness or permanent distorted state in your voice. I've even literally heard people claim that it will stay that way if you don't do that, that your voice will somehow magically stay distorted if you don't cool it down. And you can see sort of by the sarcastic, dramatic tone that I'm using that I actually don't think this is true at all. So if you've watched my other videos, especially my distortion explanation videos, you already know that most of our distorted sounds do not actually come from our actual vocal cords or vocal folds. Folds or cords are interchangeable words, folks, in case you're kind of wondering. In the case of distorted vocals, whether it's singing with distortion, speaking with distortion, or full distortion screams like fry screaming or false chord screaming, we need to be aware that the distorted part of the sound is coming from the flapping around or shaking around of tissues that are creating white noise. Most distorted sounds are not coming from something happening in your vocal cords, and they certainly shouldn't leave permanent damage to the vocal cords in any regard once we're finished making them. And this is why we want to make sure that we learn how to make the correct sounds, where the tissues in our false cords, our soft palate, our uvula, and our sinuses are rattling around and shaking to create a majority of the distortion. The best thing you can do after you're done screaming and shaking around a lot of those tissues and making a lot of distorted noises, hey, is to actually just stop. Realize that if you're doing a sort of cool down after an aggressive vocal session, you're actually just singing more and you should be resting your voice. There's absolutely nothing wrong with stopping and not talking and going into a vocal rest state as soon as you're done with your stage set or whatever sort of distorted thing you've been doing. A cool down might psychosomatically make you feel a little bit better. I'm always in favor of anything that makes someone feel a little bit more psychologically relaxed when they're vocalizing. If for you it provides a relaxation or a sort of a swelling check, you can always check if you're going hoarse by doing sort of a cool down and kind of doing some falsetto hums. These kind of things. When you do that, you can check and see if you're going hoarse, but you really don't need to. If you're doing correct screams, we shouldn't be going hoarse. And if we are using the correct tissues, it shouldn't be affecting our vocal folds. In fry screaming, we do push air between our closed vocal cords, kind of making the vocal cords create a little bit of white noise in the sound like this, like a bit, if my lips were vocal cords, you get the idea. But that is only because our tissues are soft and they're being pressed together and we're pushing air through it. That's why my lips make a good demonstration there. It's pretty much what it looks like. Just to be clear, most of our fry screaming distortion is still coming from our soft palate and the uvula and other tissues flapping around. Some of it is coming from that white noise of air going between those soft cords. But even that should not permanently in any way change the shape or condition of your vocal cords. Your vocal cords, when they're healthy, are smooth along the surface, and you should be able to return from aggressive, harsh vocals into pure, clean singing with ease if you're good at making both sounds and you have some experience. I used to do this all the time in my bands, go right into opera singing after screaming. You know, I've done all kinds of crazy things like that. Because the surface of our cords isn't changing or getting damaged or being affected by a proper scream, once the tissues are done shaking around, if we're not engaging them, our voice should simply return to normal. Because if you're not shaking around the tissues, it's not going to be distorted. We definitely don't want distortion to come from our vocal folds themselves. It's only going to come from blowing air past them or through them or onto other tissues. And once that's done, it's done. It shouldn't leave you with any continuing rasp or distortion. If for some reason your actual voice, like your speaking voice, becomes uncontrollably raspy, like you're always raspy all the time, that's a sign of vocal damage or vocal strength issues, where maybe your cords are not touching the way that they should, or there's an obstruction like a polyp or a callus on the surface of our cords preventing them from touching. And that would give us a slightly different sound than raspy singing or screaming. It's kind of this husky, like, hey, like, kind of like this a little bit, you know, permanent raspiness. What I'm actually doing there when I'm imitating that sound is holding my cords apart a little bit. And it's not very comfortable. I don't recommend doing that. But what I'm saying is, if you have some kind of permanent raspy thing going on, it's not because you were screaming. Only if you were screaming incorrectly. It's from something else happening. We can get polyps and calluses and damage from a variety of reasons. We can get vocal cord weakness from a variety of reasons. Something like being sick could give us, even if we've never sang a distorted note in our life. So we just need to be careful to understand these sounds clearly and where they're coming from. So what I say is, don't worry about a cool down. Don't panic or freak out if you haven't been cooling down. Your voice will be fine as long as you're making the correct screams to begin with. You have to be making the correct sound. That is the big caveat here. If you're making wrong sounds, you might be yelling, and then you might actually cause vocal damage, in which case a cool down still won't help you either. It's not going to change the swelling you just inflicted on your vocal cords by doing the wrong sound. In the case of hoarseness, I would recommend that you actually don't cool down at all, that you just stop immediately and you just rest your voice. Silence is the best cool down. Rest your voice for at least 20 minutes before you go back out and speak to the audience, maybe if you're a touring musician, something like that. Cool downs are going to be continuing to phonate sounds, continuing to use your cords, continuing to use your muscles, and extending the time in which you're fatiguing everything. And so I just really don't think they're necessary. Just know if you have been doing correct screams, if you don't cool down, you will not end up permanently raspy. I have not ever done cool downs since I've done screams the entire time I've been around. I've never had a polyp, a nodule, any sort of vocal damage, and you can hear that I have a nice, smooth speaking voice with no permanent raspiness. So if I'm not a good guinea pig, there's a lot of other folks out there who also have never cooled down and don't experience permanent raspiness, as long as you're making the correct screams to begin with. One of the goals of my channel, guys, is to provide clear instruction and actually tell you what's actually going on in a direct, non-abstract way to ease your fears so that you go into these things armed and educated and that you're not afraid of making certain sounds when they're correct. If you ever experience hoarseness or like stabbing or aching pains, then that's definitely time to stop what you're doing and learn how to make the sound more correctly. That's super important. Okay, everybody? If you need lessons and you're curious on how to do these techniques correctly, I've got my Screamer Series playlist, but you can always email me at voicehacks@gmail.com. I give Skype lessons to students all over the world every week. Thanks, guys, and I'll see you soon.